Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI popup control. The popup control is a useful tool for displaying alert messages with customizable buttons or loading any desired view inside a popup. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI popup control to a .NET MAUI project. I will also demonstrate how to customize the position, size, and layout of the popup. Before you begin, please ensure that you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the necessary .NET MAUI workload. Additionally, make sure that you have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click on Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, provide the project name and location. After that, proceed to create the project using the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the environment for running the application. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Now, I will run the application and show you the default output. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the popup control into this application. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI popup NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI popup package and select it to install in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. To do this, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion Core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. You can generate a trial license key by following the instructions provided in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. Remove the default code from the content page section. Then, import the Syncfusion MAUI popup namespace. And I initialize the .NET MAUI popup control inside a stack layout. And set a name for the popup. To display the popup, you need to call the show method. For that, add a button above the popup control and set its name to button. Then set its text to show popup and define the clicked event. After that, adjust its width and margin. Now, navigate to this event handler method and call the popup's show method. As you can see, when I click the button, the MAUI popup control is displayed at the center on the emulator. Now, I'll show you how to display the popup content at different positions, such as center, absolute, and relative. To open a popup at specific x and y coordinates, add the x and y values to the show method. I set x to 50 and y to 100. Look here, when I click the button, the popup is displayed at the specified coordinates. To open the popup relative to a view, use the show relative to view method instead of the show method. Set the view parameter to button and the popup relative position parameter to align bottom. Notice that, when you click the button, the popup is displayed below the button. Next, I'll show you how to customize the layout. Before starting, change the popup positioning method to show and navigate to the main page XAML. To show the popup's footer with buttons, set the show footer property to true. And define the appearance mode property to show one or two buttons in the footer view. Here, I set it to two buttons. Now, observe that the two buttons, decline and accept, are shown in the popup's footer. To display the popup without a header, set the show header property to false. Now, the header is not displayed on the popup. To display the close icon, set the show close button property to true. By default, the popup will be displayed without a close icon. Additionally, make sure to set the show header property to true. You can observe that a close icon is displayed on the popup. Now, let me show how to change the text for the popup message, header, and footer buttons. To change the message text, use the message property and set the desired text. To change the header text, use the header title property and set the desired text. To change the accept and decline buttons text, use the accept button text and decline button text properties. For example, you can set accept button text to yes and decline button text to no. See, the customized text is displayed in the popup message, header, and footer buttons. Next, I will show you how to create a customized popup that alerts the user about blocking a contact. Before I start, remove the code changes for the popup message, header, and footer buttons text changes, and set the show close button to false. Now, to customize the header, define the header template property and assign a data template to it. Inside the data template, add a label and set its text property to a desired header text. Customize the label further by setting properties like font attributes, font size, horizontal text alignment, vertical text alignment, and padding. To customize the popup content, define the content template property and assign a data template to it. Inside the data template, add a label and set its text property to the desired content. Customize the label by adjusting properties like text color, horizontal text alignment, vertical text alignment, and padding. To customize the footer, define the footer template property and assign a data template to it. Inside the data template, add a button to confirm the blocking action. Set its text property to click to confirm. Further customize the button by specifying width and height requests, text color, background color, and font size. Now, you can observe that the popup effectively communicates the action of blocking contact to the user. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion popup control to it. I also showed how to customize the position, size, and layout of the popup. To learn more about popup features, check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.